Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create a menu bar in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running.
All right, people, let's create a menu bar. Not too different from the menu bar that you see at the top of many programs. There's usually a tab for file, edit, view, help, stuff like that, except we're going to create one that doesn't have as many options or features. It's going to be the generic brand menu bar, like the Walmart variety. So let's begin by creating a window. So window equals tk followed by window.mainloop. Then we're going to create a menu bar and add menus to the menu bar. And each menu is going to function like a drop-down menu where you hover over one of these tabs and there's a drop-down. So we need a menu bar. Let's just call this menu bar. Menu bar equals menu. And we're adding this to our window. So then we're going to take window.config and we can set the menu of this window to equal the menu bar that we just created. With each of these tabs for your menu bar, you need to create a separate menu and add each menu to your menu bar, and the menu bar is added to the window. There's different levels to this stuff. So let's create a file menu because, well, this one has a file menu. Why not our program? So file menu equals menu, kind of like what we did with our menu bar, except instead of adding this to our window, we're going to add this to our menu bar. So menu bar, like that. There's one other step too. We need to use this function, menu bar dot add underscore cascade. This will have a drop-down menu sort of effect. So let's create a label just called file to mimic the file tab that you see at the top of many programs. So label file, and we're going to set the menu to equal the file menu that we created. So file menu. And let's take a look just to see what we have. So here's our menu bar, and here's our menu. There's a drop-down effect for this, but we need to add actual options to this file menu. So let's do that. So let's begin by creating, let's see, we got maybe open, save, and exit. That should be good. So file menu dot add underscore command. So this is a clickable option, and let's create a label called open, and we can open a file and maybe two more. So we got open, save, and exit. Open, save, exit. And let's take a look at this. So here's the drop-down menu. We can open, save, exit. Now you might notice that there's this annoying line. This is called a tear off. You can actually get rid of this if you want. So when we create this file menu, we're going to set tear off to equal zero, and that should get rid of that. And it's gone. So sometimes you might see a line to separate sections. Well, you can do that with a separator. So let's separate the exit command that we have from open and save. And to add that separator, we just type in the name of our menu, file menu dot add separator. So this will separate your different commands from each other within a menu. You can see that there is a line between save and exit because we placed a separator here. Now, if you want each of these file commands to actually do something, you need to associate a command with each of these commands. It's a command within a command. So command equals, for our open file command, we'll create a function called open file. And we'll need to declare that function. And then let's create a command called save file. And then another called exit. Actually, one shortcut, if you want to exit something, you can just say quit. All right, let's create an open file and a save file function. So def open file. Let's just print something just to keep this simple. I already have another video on opening files. So print file has been opened. And let's do the same thing for save file. File has been saved. And then our last command, exit, will just quit. So let's try this. So let's go to file. Here's the drop-down menu. We can open a file. File has been opened. We can save a file. And then exit. And exit will close out of our window. Let's create a second menu called edit to mimic the one that we have at the top of our IDE. So let's create a edit menu. So it's the same process that we did with our file menu. So let's call this edit menu equals menu. We're adding this to our menu bar. And I do not want a tear off, so tear off equals zero. Then for the next line, we need to add cascade. So I'm going to copy this. Menubar.addCascade. The label name will be edit. And the file, I mean the menu, will be edit menu. And we're setting this menu that we're adding to edit menu. And let's try this. So we have file and edit, but we need to add commands to this edit menu. So it's the same process that we did with our file menu. I'm just going to copy this, change file to edit, and let's make a command called cut, copy, and paste. So the label will be cut. We'll create a command called cut. We'll copy this, and we'll create another command called copy, and then paste. All right, then we just need to create some functions for this. So cut, copy, paste. Let's do that at the top. So cut, you cut some text. So cut, copy, and then paste. You copied some text and paste. You pasted some text. All right, let's try this. So here's our edit menu. Here's the dropdown. We can cut, we can copy, and we can paste. Not actually, but it's going to call a function that can do something like that if you want to set that up. Maybe that's a video for a different day. Let's customize these menus. Well, because we can. So let's begin by changing the font. So we can just type in within each of these menus, font equals, pick a font that you want, and then a size. So I'm going to add this font for both of these menus that we have. And then when we hover over and click on these menus, you can see that the font has changed. Did you guys know that you can actually add images next to each of these commands? Well, you can, and this is how we can do that. First, you'll need some images. Here's a few that I'm using. So add these to your project folder. I plan on using a floppy disk for save, an open folder for open, and for some reason, a stop sign for exit because I couldn't really think of anything at the moment. I guess an arrow would have worked too, I guess. So let's create some photo images out of these images. So I already did this. I'm just going to copy and paste the text that I had. So create a unique name for each image. I have open image, save image, and exit image. They're all photo images. And here is the file path or the file name for each of these pictures that I'm using. So to add an image to each of these commands, when you add the command, we can just say image and then the photo image that you want to use. So with my open command, I'm going to use this open image photo image that I have, and this is the open folder. So I'm going to do the same thing for save and exit. So we have save image and exit image. But when we run and compile this, let's take a look. Yeah, so all the text is gone. That's going to be a problem. So we'll need to compound these. So with compound, we can add an image on a certain side of the text and keep the text. So compound, let's say we want the image on the left. So compound left, and I'm just going to add this to each of these commands. And now we should have an image as well as some text. Well, that's the basics of creating a menu bar in Python. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's how you can create a simple menu bar in Python.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.